Mother, this is the beginning of the journey of another birthday weekend. So we're driving beautiful sky today. Dave's behind me in the car and we're heading off to get some supplies for food and stuff like that, because I know that you said that you want us to slave. So Dave, we're away to get supplies.
Mate, I'm so excited. I've been up from 5:30 this morning drinking liquor and looking for my ma.
So Dave forgot his shorts, his swim shorts.
Yeah, because we're going to have to use this with all the meat and the shit that's going to be happening.
And down this aisle here.
Down
there? On down. So we're looking for big man's speedos.
Big man's sled.
There, wee 6 pound one. Look at that. Have they got big? Oh, three,
oh, yeah.
Look at that. Crew three colours
too. 6 pounds.
So we're looking at all the wines.
Have you ever had jammy?
So there we are, Yvonne, off the corn. Beautiful day, look at that for a day. Beautiful. And we're heading up a coast now, so we're going to go through the Black Arch. It's actually not called the Black Arch, do you know that? It's called the Dry Arch.
So it only took about 20 minutes to get from Larne to our actual location where we're going to stay for the next couple of days, but we decided to go on up the coast a wee bit more, maybe about 15 minutes longer of a journey to a golf course. Most people got lost. Philip ended up in the top of a mountain, spiraled his way down to where we were, and most people ended up all at the same time, which was really handy. But the drive itself was beautiful. Like, look at these coast roads. Absolutely beautiful. So it was a nice little drive. We were relaxed, but whenever we got there, everybody was just starving.
Gives a big smile, Mum.
I don't know where to sit.
Sit here.
Just sit here.
We're all hiding our chins.
He doesn't care.
Yeah. I know you get 2 bits of scallions and you take a photograph of him with Dave. Right, son, now.
When you're getting chomped, that's you. She's really good at Dub for dubber.
And you don't want to change your meal at all or customise it? Or
no, because we're in by hobby. No, I'm a new man.
So every time we've ever had anything, he always wants to customise everything.
This is a new meal.
So if he's ordering beef, he'll say, can I have instead of the beef, the lamb? Or instead of, if it says you get chips with it, say, instead of chips, can I get egg?
Oh, can I have
What's he like, Lindsay?
No.
You can't take him anywhere.
But you can't.
So Phil drove up that, look at that, beautiful, beautiful day. He drove up and he hated every mile.
Every mile of it, every mile. He came up over the mountain.
He came right over the top of this mountain, right down.
He's spawned down it.
You get me?
Did you do the baby reindeer on somebody?
Well, she was a star. and I'm glad because I love wee tiny fat women.
Fat women like me.
No, we.
Why are you
getting
my wife?
Well, she's not me, she's wrong. Oh. Do you know what I mean? But, and she won Netflix, and then after I closed
it. She was crazy though.
Sure, we love crazy.
So would you have sat out on a bus shelter till like 3 in the morning waiting on a man?
Yes, you would have.
She stayed up at night with a hatchet for the dad.
They kill friggin' dogs with needles now.
This one's for Christopher. Like, I wasn't really truly her. When you think of it, but I was a quarter of her.
That's still enough.
I always remember I stopped Stephen.
Did you?
Oh yes, if Stephen wasn't there.
So the food ended up being really good. We took another little drive back down to the base, which was about 15 minutes down the road. All got our rooms in, and it was a nice wee drive back.
So here we are, we're outside the place. Beautiful day. This is it. Let's do a wee tour before it all gets dirty. So first door you can't get into.
Second door. You can. So that's the kitchen area. That's just where all the magic will happen. And then another little tour. Oh, a wee back garden with a barbecue, nonetheless. Handy. Another wee kitchen area where the PDs can sit. Oh, man, that's your present. And we will find a space for you, Lindsay, that's going to be quiet.
Yes, please.
So Lindsay actually hates staying with us because we're so noisy as a family, but we're going to find her somewhere that she can hide.
Right above the kitchen?
Right above the kitchen, Lindsay.
Where are you?
Yeah.
So this is all the rooms. It's pretty big. Pretty big.
So
out of everywhere that Siobhan has ever picked for us to stay in, this actually was a fantastic little space, and actually really enjoyed it and thought it was perfectly located. Everything inside it was lovely, so she actually pulled a blinder. Won't ever tell her that though. And then I end up staying in this little cupboard room. Look at that. See that wee evil cupboard to the right?
Are they making you carry all your own stuff? Like a homeless. Look at you. Sad music on here.
Right, there's a
farm lit
here and it's all
wee
diamonds lit up.
Where?
There. The lights.
This is actually the most work I've ever seen my mum carry anything in her life. Mum, are you okay carrying all that?
Just look at that bad boy.
So against the shade off you.
Look at the side of that big bad boy.
So against the side of your stomach.
Sugar pit.
So this is us all unloading loads of alcohol, and then this is the situation we have here. So we have three kegs machines all ready to go.
Oh, there's Lindsay in the shot again.
I know. So let's get a wee quick update on the fridge situation here. So there's the meat. Which is
to it. No, it was the moment.
No, absolutely not. It's beer pong.
We have beer pong.
Okay.
We have first date, which is actually really good. It's questions that you want to know about each other.
Oh.
Categories. Articulate.
Okay. What?
5 second rule. Right, Christopher. And describe it.
That's a lot of games.
I know.
And oh my goodness. Shit. We'll get them into the freezer then. Make them at least interesting.
Are we good? Does he sell ice? Because we need ice
enough. Nicola's just been told that she's not allowed to go swimming yet. We're going tomorrow. Look at me fish skills. She was all ready.
So believe it or not, this is my mum's Christmas present, and for some reason it got lost in Nicola's house and it ended up in the back of my car right up until now, which is her birthday, so not a better time to give her it than today.
What's this? I'm ready.
Look like you're going to a bank. Okay. So look at how happy Nicola is. Look at how unhappy I am. So we're currently...
Look how happy I am. You're not getting in.
So we're approaching the sea. And we've talked all ourselves into actually getting... So it looks a lovely sunny day, but don't let that fool you. Because it's absolutely melting. And whenever it's cold outside, it means it's 10 times colder inside. So I'm not happy at all. And we're going to get into the water here in a couple of seconds. I feel a wee bit like hard done by that. Lindsay's not going to get in, my mum's not going to get in, so I don't want to stay in too long. Phil, what about the quality of the water we're going to get into?
It's shit! See all the houses that you can see on that hillside? It's literally what we're climbing into. Is there poo? It's just fucking gross, man.
I'm not happy. I'm really not happy with this.
You could get washed.
Look at how happy she is. I actually see this guy here and thought, there's a local going to get in. It must be like a thing that they all do. I didn't even know that was Andy. Look at the state of this here. I don't even know what I'm looking at there. Right, unhappy, but I'm going to do it.
Chris,
see if I throw.
Hello, Chris.
Nigel, why did you not get in?
Cold feet. That is not summery.
How far did you take that?
You took that to there?
Yeah, it went to here.
That's pretty good. I got to there. How far did you go? Oh, that's nasty.
No. Well, it's slightly better when you go back in, actually.
Oh. Right, so this is proof that I've actually got into the water.
Dave, look at the size of your vagina.
I want to do this so much. I want to actually get out into the wet. But it's so cold. It's a good night for it, I'll give you that.
Yeah, they come back out. Yeah.
Sunblock me.
Well, what do you think, Mum, of everybody getting in the water?
Oof. Oh, it's hot.
He's the guest son you have, actually, that one. So there is what we get into.
Woo! 10 degrees. 10 degrees.
Look at how happy she is. We was just. So now it's the walk of shame back to the place we're staying in. We're doing a bit of a walk of shame back.
Right, so Phil, what's happened to you since you've had a house?
I'm not going to say that on camera.
It's only going to be on Mum's show.
You put that on YouTube.
No, it's only for this one.
Are you looking at me lifting the big chair?
Yes. Why are you lifting the big chair? Look at that chair. Right, so right now, David is taking our food order for tonight. This is what he's doing. Look at him. Look at his serious face.
See what he's
always
saying.
I'm sure you're free to be shit.
This is what Dave looks like when he's solving COVID.
David! He told us during COVID that they were building fucking labs where they're going to microchip us. You had the green machine?
Yeah.
Yeah. What the fuck happened to it? I told you 6 years in production, you dick. Well, that was fucking 5 years.
This is exactly why I bring Lindsay away with me. She's a wee silly fan at heart, even though she supports the Spurs.
I drank half of it already.
Dave, where do we get the Chinese from?
Have you seen Christine's shot? Christine, give us a shot.
That would put me in bed.
Yeah.
Right, there we have...
She's giving more light.
Christopher,
she's giving more light.
Hello. Don't label them all, Deborah.
Lucifer.
Go.
Can I see it?
Right now?
No.
Philip told me what? To eat the prawns.
Alright.
Can I ask?
Because
question?
That prawn died for me.
Thank you.
What the, I have the prawn to commit suicide. What am I meant to say?
Aren't they?
Well, what are we going to say about that?
Yeah,
eat the prawns because they died for you.
I think they look
that was
like
him. Don't do that.
But why are you so dark?
What?
Why are you so dark?
Is your robot hat? Nice.
Right, are we all ready for games night? That was literally so bad! That was so
9!
11.
9!
9!
So, Hey, here we go! Look at that!
Get your eyes! If you have a baby girl.
Pig!
Yes, one. Okay. It's the TV shows you used to love watching all the time.
Dexter.
No.
Porn.
Friends. No, it's like they've done an American version and an English version.
The Office.
No, the other one. James McAvoy. Yes.
Shameless.
Okay. Trevor McDonald always done it.
The News.
The
News. Okay. Whenever you're giving somebody a recording of something, you're giving them a
video.
Video, yep, well done. Yep. Okay. It's where that game was.
Sure,
where
sure.
Game to solve it.
Things of
you're like me now.
Shalom, I preferred you when you weren't talking.
So after all these years, we've found out that Siobhan says "right so" quite a lot, and she does not like that we know that.
Imagine saying your mother's
uncle. She cannot
what an absolute
not say
fucking villain.
So right.
So
right.
That's just not right.
Can we do it
in a team of
no?
Right. No. Right. So if
you
do it in a team of three.
That's unreal.
One of them is like on a
parent.
That's
unreal.
A team of three, but one of them is fucked up, is what she's
right,
saying.
Right, no, so.
I love it. I love it.
On start.
Right, so.
You're out of your fucking
head. So. No. Right, so you do it in half, three and a half.
So,
two teams.
What are you doing?
Oh, God. Jelly bean?
Right, so take control
right, okay.
Here. Take
right,
control.
Right.
What the fuck's that?
Right, and so one, two, three, four, five.
There's absolutely no doubt about it. We are a loud family, and when we play any game, we become actually uncontrollably loud. It's disgusting.
Seven seconds.
I've been trying to give you the answer.
Do you know what people are screaming at you around you? You may be hearing the wrong.
Stuart won't be here next
right,
year.
Nigel's got serious. He's clipped on glasses here. Like.
Right, are we ready to go?
Yeah.
Right. Don't show me.
They were gone minutes ago.
Don't accuse your answer.
So what kind of my wife?
Keep them close to you, show you. Not accusing.
Right, go.
Go.
When you change age, what's it called?
Birthday party.
Birthday.
Growing older.
He said age, that's very similar to birthday.
Quicker, Nigel!
When you're going out, as a lady, what do you put on?
Dress!
With what type of dress?
Thongs!
No.
That party dress.
Long evening
dress! Evening dress, formal dress.
Long dress.
Evening dress, yes.
There's a triple Casey Jane.
Wait, what are we talking about, Dave?
Because we were talking about. That is horrible. Nine. Phil, that's 9 points.
The whole thing.
Nine.
Like you're on the TikTok shop. So advertise it.
Okay.
So lift it up.
We are
high
nine. Nine.
Talk about how the tin would look.
9.5, Christopher.
How would it look in the fridge right now?
In the fridge, it would look fucking freezing. Oh.
How does the ring poo?
Oh shit,
how does the ring poo?
I don't
know,
it's actually
nice. Hey Dave, talk us through
it. I know, Mum. I forgot about Christopher's stench.
Dave on TikTok.
We're on TikTok.
Yeah, I'm trying to ignore it.
I was right.
Oh, Chris.
Hard to concentrate.
Right, the farts left.
Right, so I'll start off.
So,
what we've got today is a new BrewDog.
Brand spanking.
Black, green, brand new design. Beautiful. Dave, what does it taste like? What's the taste like?
We haven't tasted this.
No, come on! Is it lovely?
It's beautiful. If you've tasted the Hazy Jane, where were my fingers
going?
Hazy Jane, and it's a lovely, smooth, beautiful.
Right, so it's called Triple Hazy Jane because it's like three of them in one. Phil, how much would you pay for one can?
I would say a
£1.10.
How much is this?
Guess.
$4.50 is a bargain right now in the TikTok shop.
It is actually $4.50.
$4.50.
Is that
two gangsters?
No, it's brand spanking new. What is it? Oh shit, it's black and it's green. Lime. And then you go realise this. Shit, it's 9.5. We're going first time live on national TV.
Right.
Brand new glass. Right, I'm going to give you half the shit. Tell me what it tastes like. Honest opinion.
It tastes a wee bit like Heineken mixed with...
Say banana.
Banana.
Smell it.
Why are you still drinking harp? Why are you drinking harp?
Right, here we go. Nigel,
there's an opinion.
Last time you said it tasted like mother's milk or something like that. No one knew what that meant.
That's pretty tasty. You can taste a bit of hops, you can taste a bit of sweetness, a bit of.
Sweetness. Banana?
Don't say banana. So this is the physics machine.
Okay, here we go.
Seriously, now you have to
kick it. I'm very serious about this.
Look at the car.
Well, he slapped it.
You spunk it.
Dave, is that the perfect head? Look at the head on that!
That's $4.50 room!
What are you laughing at?
It's the funniest. It's 9.5. Phil, say the camera
9.5. 9.
Put it in your mouth.
I'll just do it.
See if you say banana, I smack your face.
Don't you say banana?
See if you say banana.
I tell you what.
Don't you say banana?
It tastes a wee bit like shit.
I'll have to go again then.
Because we're going again. We're really serious.
Get out of his face.
We're gonna send this to BrewDog for them to run as an ad.
It tastes like if you were on the field and you had literally put your face into sheep shit, but then pulled out of it. Dave, why are you laughing? And then drank some lemon. This is it. 9.5% is pretty good. It's pretty good.
Nice.
No banana. I don't think it's that.
No banana.
Mate, we trust you right now. I believe in you.
Do you want to close all the doors, sweetheart?
Talk to us, Nigel. Tell us, give us your words.
Mate, I need you right now.
Give us your words.
Right.
please be honest.
Right, honestly, I think it's lovely, and I think I could drink it all night.
No, but what
you could, because you would die. You would die from alcohol poisoning.
Right, so Dave has bought the biggest piece of meat.
Yeah.
That I think I've actually ever seen a man buy.
Look at that. Look at the colour.
Sugar pit.
Sugar pit.
Yeah.
What is a sugar pit?
Sugar pit, it's been cured, manicured, and seared, and man-seared. I don't know.
So Dave got this fantastic big whack of pork, which was like 20 quid, and it was able to feed everybody and leave like tons left for 20 quid. We made a little spice rub in my house before I left and just threw it all on, set on slow and low. So it meant that the rest of the day we could just go enjoy the day and then come back to this all Lexi cooked and ready for us. So basically threw it into the oven, left it, and it was absolutely amazing for later. So there, we made it the whole way up to watch the boat leave on us.
We could have got it. We could have been there.
We could have been there. It was such a lovely day too for it, so that we could have ended up over there on this island drinking. But to be fair, I've drunk quite a lot already today, or yesterday. They're probably doing me for today. So you almost made the ferry. Right, Mumsy, you're taking.
You're just going to put it in front of me.
Yes.
It's absolutely beautiful, and I can't get over. It's a boat.
Andy, where's your son?
Oh, look at these two wee lesbians taking forever.
Unbelievable. I'm going to put the sunglasses on.
Okay. There they go.
I just said that bit there, Naomi, don't believe it. Show you the brain and the stomach goes.
It's not. Put your
head. Look down.
You're filled in all art.
Just trying to get the find leading lanes.
You won't give me a sip of your coffee.
Don't touch my coffee, you wee slut.
It's a demon's under the water.
Inside Raffin Island, Nicola, what's your first impression?
It is a shame Lindsay's not here. But
I love it because I love the sea and I love all the Baltic surf and
it was fun. It was enjoyable.
So this is how it looks. So we kind of fishing village. You've got like, there is a bit of cloud here, but the sun is just about to pop out. Like the sun wants to come out. Andy, what did we just hear?
Fucking live music playing down there. Fucking puffins.
Right, so we're here.
Yeah.
In where are we, Dave?
We're Rathlin Island, where the puffins puff.
Yep, so we've just heard that on Rathlin Island there's either a restaurant or a pub or a walk to the lighthouse.
And a post office.
And a post office. And that's pretty much it.
That's it.
And what we've heard behind us here is a little pub with a wee bit of
Fiddly D.
Wee bit of Fiddly D. So we're going to go on Fiddly D with ourselves.
Yeah, so we're going to have a wee drink. So catch us later.
I feel like you were standing out all in. Where's Dave playing? The glasses here on the red shirt.
So today was really special, just like coming to this island for the first time ever, spending it with my family and listening to this music and the sun shining, pints flowing, wow. So me and Philip took a little trip just outside of the bar and down onto the beach, and my goodness, the weather was amazing.
Right, so Phil, where are we here? What are we doing?
On a shitty island that we actually paid money for. Even though we live on an island, we actually give this company, this boat, money to come to an island. And literally there's nothing on it other than a bar.
Yeah,
but it is nice. And the
how nice has it been?
The paints are nice. Other than that,
there's ducks and all in the water. You wouldn't even get that back in Northern Ireland.
Where's the duck? That's one duck.
There's plural.
So other than one duck, we have a couple of boats that are obviously abandoned.
Yep.
And we have obviously run out of money.
Run out of money. They rely on us to just keep buying more pints for them. So here we go. There's
a wee pint shot. Look at that. That's the cool photograph. Well done.
Wandering along here, marveling at some of the buildings. So yeah. Somebody's decided that they just want to paint the chimney purple. Do you know what that's been, Phil? Boredom.
Yeah, or they've run out of white paint.
They've
and they only had that wee tin left in the shed.
And a wee tin of yellow for the top of the other one.
For fuck's sake.
Right, so that was the end of a fantastic day. Actually, we really liked that, didn't we?
Oh, if you've got a stone,
and I have a wee stone belonging to the memory, and what a beautiful song.
And I can't wait to when go into your handbag and take it out and throw it away.
If you've got a stone inside, you need to pass it.
Right, so we had a couple of pints. Me and Phil took a wee walk and just seen a bit more of the town, and beautiful day, look at the sky outside, so everybody's really happy. We've got the crazy locals. Look at that one there, he sees broken. So this is the normal game that they play here. It's called Sheep Child. This is our wee ferry home, so we're all like trying to make our way up to it. My mum is notoriously slow for walking, so she's back down there somewhere, so we're gonna have to tell the captain of the boat hang on for my mum. So the guy wants to leave here, it's 2 minutes to go, and there is my mother.
My mum's gonna have to do a run and jump.
Hobbling. She's gonna have to jump on.
She's gonna have to jump.
Because she's to get from there onto the boat here. So we just made it on the moat, and Mum made it on within. Andy, how much time does she have left?
Not much, like literally they're close to the
gate. I'm
going to
say 3 seconds.
Yeah.
Right, so that concludes the trip. That was actually really good fun.
Yeah, so we've got duck eggs and we've got turkey eggs.
Yeah, we're going to try a turkey egg for the first time.
I didn't even know turkey eggs even actually existed.
And we're going to eat all their children. All your children are going to get out.
So that ended the little trip to Rathlin Island, and I must say I would love to go back there, and I would love to go back on a day as nice and as pretty as what today was. It was blue, there was no wind, it was amazing. So we headed over to this little bar, which is literally across the street from where we were staying. Absolutely class wee spot.
So
So we're in a wee bar across the street right now, and had a busy day, but it's nice actually coming here and having a wee bit of a drink.
I actually managed to get
and mine was,
we're all sunburned as well.
Look at this.
Chris,
Sunny, bitch, horny. Yeah.
What's that? What?
To explain who I am.
Three words.
I'm sturdy, welcoming, loving.
Yeah. Loving. Yeah. Yeah.
And then, welcoming, nerdy, lovable.
And then for Nicola, three words to describe her.
Don't be me.
So, drunk, liar, and then third word, liar.
These are so mean. Is it for Christopher?
Three words for me.
Oh, that's easy. Dedicated. Well, if you can say works too hard in a word.
What do you call that?
Former carer.
And no. How can you say works too hard in one word?
Lee and Dave, in my eyes, one word. Roy.
No, I know. Infiltrator.
Oh, yeah. I'll give
you
that one.
Okay, so
I'm going to actually say smart.
Yeah. Savvy.
Smart.
Oh, we need to get out of these three words now.
Made you look so good.
Yeah,
yeah.
Amanda. So, Mum, we were away on a holiday. Stop going so close. We were away on a holiday and you want to hear this, right?
Oh,
so, Christopher and I were to share a bed together.
Ooh.
And Christopher, for 6 months, had sharpened his toenails into a point. So that in the middle of the night he would do this.
So as he could get it.
Yeah. And I ended up sharing a bed with Emily, so it was fine. But then when we went to the water park, here was him behind me. One.
Oh, let go. Shred it.
Oh.
Look at that.
Pull that.
Oh, look at that. Look at that.
Hey, Nigel. Tell everybody, what are you doing?
I'm busy shredding up this lovely.
What are you doing?
Shredding.
I think this is
shredding this lovely loin.
But that's not what you do now.
Look at the special babies. We're going to do this week.
Our chief shredder. Look at the special babies wearing.
Oh, look at that. Yeah, you grab it here. There you go.
So every year we cook a little meal, and Mum this year, when she heard that we weren't going to cook as much this year, she actually phoned us and insisted that we cooked a really big meal. So we've done it for you, Mummy. This is the special meal that we made, and we hope that you enjoyed it, because actually everybody did.
I miss Lindsay too. I'll miss her later.
Lynn's happy with her.
Right. I need an
order
rack for that one,
Christopher. Yeah.
Your
dinner,
I
get
the
eggs. So good. Hey, excellent.
Anyone like cheese?
Cheese.
Oh, that is spicy.
Happy birthday to
you. Oh, give me some surprise.
Happy birthday.
Right? Stuart's done us this special little concoction.
Happy birthday,
Mother. Cheers. Nigel. What's this? Honestly, next time I see you, it'll be Northwest.
If you had to kill one of your children to save the rest, then which one would you kill? Quick, 5 seconds.
I don't think I can have that choice.
You have to.
You've got one choice.
Well then, just David, he's the oldest.
Exactly, David.
When I, were,
Do you want to know how she would have killed me? See, earlier on, I was eating that beautiful pork and hearing me, oh, look at that lovely caramelized pork. You're fucking carbonara chili.
Okay, that's the end of
the thing. Oh, I didn't
mean
it
either.
What are you doing? Oh, you're
recording
me? No. Asuka. No!
That's when you get anal twice.
Anyway, this was just a dummy round.
No, hold on. Christopher's about to apologize to me because he handed the cards and he thought that I had done 10.
Okay.
And
I'm going to apologize. No. Just stop getting on about it.
Apologize.
Sorry you felt that way.
Do you get it?
Oh.
You didn't apologize.
I did.
You didn't.
Watch.
Did you put 2 down?
Christopher.
The world of championship of balls.
Six pillow fights.
A recent laboratory study shows that undergraduates have 50% less sex after being exposed to Justin Bieber. A recent laboratory undergraduates have 50% less sex after being exposed to a microphone. Have 50% less sex after being exposed to children on leases.
What?
That's brutal.
I'm gonna win this one.
Sexy pillow fights. You look evil.
I do.
So it's the last day and it's Sunday, Dave. What have you discovered up the street?
Well, the fact, funny enough, I went up to the woman in the shop and I said, eggs? And she says, yes, and top left hand side went up and we had these, just ordinary bog standard eggs. So right next to it, it was all sitting all fresh. I went, turkey? Yes, turkey eggs, yeah. I mean, turkey eggs. He says, yes. And these are the size of the turkey eggs, so they're actually pretty
massive,
big.
Yeah.
So, it's £50 each. I went, no, okay. I've never had a turkey egg.
Uh-huh.
So I went over to her and I leaned on the counter, leaned over, and I went, so, what way would you cook a turkey egg? So then, for her, she then bent over the counter and went, you fat any other way, you would any other egg. So,
Here we go. Is it? Yeah, so we're gonna crack on and make this.
Stop spending all your money buying cheap eggs when you can have the most amazing turkey eggs. I never knew these things even existed until today. I've been trying them and my goodness, they're so creamy. They're actually just like bigger, better and bolder in general. And you get a whole lot more egg for your money. So look, if you're cooking eggs, you love eggs and you know that eggs are good for you, start using turkey eggs and get rid of those wee cheap papery powdered hen eggs. Let me know which eggs you love best.
So here we go. Hit this bad boy. So I want to get a wee bit of...
Well, what's a turkey egg like, Div?
Getting a lot of yolk. And it's very creamy.
Is it?
It's actually quite nice, actually.
That is another end to one of my mother's day trip weekends. Not even a day trip. So behind me, this is where we were staying. And had a fantastic wee time, actually, so it was really good fun. We are now going to say goodbye to this wee trip. Happy birthday, Mummy.
Your bedroom, your hair.
Nicola?
Yes.
I didn't look high, so there's a bar. Right, so what was your favourite moment of the break?
Definitely when we got off the boat, I felt safe. And then we done a wee dander, right, and we went to some bar, hotel, whatever, and there was 10 people with fiddles and bagpipes and whistles and guitars, violins. Oh wow, 10 of them and 2 girls sang a blue whistles, right, and absolutely there wasn't even a breeze on my hair, just really. And I think I relaxed too much, it just went like that.
Yeah, it was a good one then. It was probably absolutely one of my favourite parts of the holiday,
yeah,
as well.
Yeah, that's true.
And then
back on the ship, I met a wee woman at 93, and she worried. And all her life, she worried. And tomorrow night, she'd be in her grave. And all that worry. Bless her.
Very good. So, now that you're a year older, what have you learned?
I'm getting more stiffer. No pain, but stiff. Should have spoke that out.
Well, you still look good and you're still moving good for your age.
Well, not bad. It's just that I can't wait to sit in the armchair.
So can I. I'm looking forward to getting home.
That was a wee bit odd. That every chair was just, you know what I mean? So, being with the children is just a thrill and a happiness and total contentment. It's a whole six of them being there. And that was the winner of everything, and that's why I like to do it every year. We're the winners.
Right, Dawn, what are we doing right now?
Going to get a picture by church with every single person.
Dave, were you wrong about the gate?
Yes, but the forest is over there.
he's just my dad, I think. He's just my dad.
I'm just kidding.
We've been standing here for about 17 hours waiting on my mum. I don't know what happened to her, where she ended up, but here she comes. So I'll have to go and get her again because she got lost.
So we finished up the whole trip with a couple of little photographs of everyone, and it took way longer than it ever should have, but we got the lovely pictures from Mum's calendar for next year. And it's nice just to have these memories, because I don't always get these with families, and it's been amazing, guys. So it's been 49 minutes, get in. Well done. See you next year.